Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Wynn and I'm a professional watercolorist and art teacher. Today I'm going to show you step by step how to create a simple leaf. Let's go! Okay, so here's my supplies. So I'm going to use the Real Value Princeton brush. This is a flat stroke brush. It's 3/4, and this is the number 2 round brush by Princeton as well. And you know, I went over to Hobby Lobby and I found this dagger brush, and I want to experiment with this and show you what you can do with this. I'm going to dip my 3/4 flat brush into the water first and get it as wet as possible. Basically, I'm going to stay on this side. This is over here is burnt sienna, and we have yellow ochre, cad yellow, and cad red. So let's start off with a little bit of that. Well, this is a big brush, so it took a lot of the cad yellow. So we're going to start with a straight line, and then we'll curve it just slightly. So I'm just going to turn it to the side, almost use it like a pencil, and see if I can turn it up a little bit. So I'm just using the edge, and then this will be the stem that sticks out. So you kind of start off straight, but you know, no leaf is perfectly straight. So I try to start off a little thinner at the top. And from here, you want to pick a spot. So I like to do the bones, or the you know, kind of the bones of the leaf. So I like to start off by just doing a quick little stem there, as if there's no skin to it. Okay, almost looks like an arrow. And then you kind of go out like this, and here's some more of that. And it doesn't have to be perfectly geometric, but just kind of going for, and they don't have to line up perfectly, just showing you the very top of the leaf. So now that you have that, you could let this dry and go over it, or you can do wet onto wet. So it's really your choice. So I'm going to clean off my brush and put a little bit of this red, cad red on here. Okay, so we got the cad red. I'm gonna mix just a tiny bit of that cad yellow. I want you to slant your brush just slightly, and from here you can kind of just create your first little petal, or you know, the skin of the leaf, and kind of come out here. Okay, so you can just keep repeating this, and you just kind of start turning your leaves as you go out. So you kind of start flat, and then you come to a point. Okay, so you just keep repeating that process. Since this is a bigger brush, I can do a lot with that with just a few strokes. And just kind of come up to a point, keep going like that. So you're using just the side of the brush going up. And now we're almost there to our point. Okay, so I'm hitting the edge of my paper. I'm using 140-pound cold press paper. It's Arches. And so from here, you can let this dry, and you could do all of your, you know, all of your leaf designs, all the little details in there. I would just keep going and see how much paint you can get off of this and watch the different effects. So I'm going to start right over again, right next to here. You can see that this one's a lot darker than this one. So you could go over that a few times. What are your favorite types of leaves to paint? Let me know in the comments below. So, looking at our other brushes here, let's use this This is a quarter dagger brush, so it's flat and has a dagger point to it. So let's try that. So if I wanted, so I'll show you for demonstration, if I wanted to grab some more deep, intense red and just put it right in there, that's gonna start creating some really interesting wet into wet types of patterns. If you wanted just to have the outside edges, that would work as well. So you just kind of go back over your edges and you can see how it could nicely, I'm gonna clean it off. I have two areas for water, one for my dirty water and then one for clean water right after. So then I would add some more water in here and just kind of go along the edges if you want to create that faded look. Now with this last little brush, you can also start off. This is the number two round. Okay, so that's a nice start for that leaf. Okay, remember, don't worry about the shapes because that, I mean, there's so many different shapes. I tried to keep it similar, but every little, you know, nook and cranny is gonna look different. And you can let this dry. And let's say we wanna add some yellow ochre. Let's see, once it's wet into wet, you can always add some more coloring in there and really create some nice effects. Or some of this, cutting off my brush first. Okay, so that's my burnt sienna. So you could come back in here and do a darker inside pattern there and mix some of the burnt umber. It's really up to you. Coming back in and creating those lines back again.
If this video was helpful for you or gave you new insight into watercolor, please hit that like and subscribe button to be notified of my videos each week. See you in the next one.